a neighbor, neighbors, they likely saved a black man's life by responding in this way. Here's the first video.
What's going on? I'm so confused. Like, what are they even talking about? I don't have no weapon, sir.
He's holding a phone.
I have no weapon. This is a speaker. I don't have anything on me.
He has nothing on him.
These beautiful people. They stood up. They saw what was happening. And they saw the potential of what could have happened. Then a bystander does something amazing. Here it is.
You don't have a gun. Come here with your hands.
I can't even see anything, man.
I know, I can't see anything either.
You want me to walk up with you, man?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, I'm gonna walk up with you, okay?
Bro, I'm just getting on the ground. I'm not even walking anywhere, bro. They're aiming guns at me.
God.
And then the officers get the go-ahead to leave and they retreat. Here it is. Let me tell you why these cops left. They left because they clearly saw the man they were about to assault or have adverse engagement with, whatever they wanted to do. They left without that engagement because they clearly saw a community had his back. This is what happens when we are a coalition. This is what happens when we operate in a spirit of unity. This is what happens when we are more concerned about drawing circles rather than drawing lines. Let's put up the picture of that scene that could have ended in a completely different way. It was last Wednesday evening when reports of gunfire and shouting near 12th and Mercer in Seattle led to a tense face-off between bystanders and East Precinct Seattle police, taking aim at a young, unarmed, not involved, completely innocent, random black male. Thankfully, as the video shows, the officers decided to retreat as bystanders gathered around the young man. Video of Wednesday's incident sent to CHS after it was recorded around 7 p.m. shows 4 minutes of the short standoff as police took their position of the dark street and one officer aimed his rifle, commanding the upset subject to drop any weapon and get on the ground. The confusing scene continued with police yelling commands as concerned bystanders told the officers to back off. According to East Precinct radio updates, police had been dispatched to the area after 911 caller reported a gunshot and a second caller reported two shots along with somebody yelling, "Everybody's going to die." But people at the scene told police there was no shouting and no gun, only a young person in a yellow sweater upset and suffering a crisis. According to radio updates, officers at the scene reported bystanders were actively hindering their response and asked for permission to back down. "We're going to go ahead and disengage," one officer says, confirming the response found no victim and no shell casings in the area, only 20 bystanders with four surrounding the subject. Isn't that something? I didn't even know that kind of call existed. So literally, a cop can call back to the precinct to say, "Hey, permission to stand down, too many community people out here." Now, if they were in a black neighborhood, they would have said, "Hey, permission to call in SWAT, the helicopter, and everything we got. We got hostiles in front of us." There's more. The witness who contacted the Capitol Hill Seattle blog said, "I was told by one witness afterwards that the precipitating incident had been the victim slapping the stop sign on the corner." That's it. The stop sign on the corner. "The victim told me he had gotten into an argument when I started to cool off. He was listening to music on his Bluetooth speaker," which is what the cops thought. "Oh, that must be a gun. Black man, something in his hand, gun." Okay? "He was terrified and sobbing when it was all over. I'm sure it did not make his temporary crisis any better." Here's the report on the incident provided by SPD. "Believing him to be possibly armed," they say, police attempted to detain the subject by giving him verbal commands at a distance. The man ignored command. As police were giving the man commands, multiple community members encircled the subject and attempted to obstruct officers' paths to approach the man while filming the incident." Now, can I say this? That would have read completely different if those members of the community were not there. That could have read, "We were in fear for our lives. We thought he had a gun. So we proceeded to engage the subject who refused to drop what we believe to be a weapon." Despite police informing citizens the man may be armed, the community members continued to interfere, they say, and became increasingly hostile based on the number of community members becoming involved and their unwillingness to comply with officers' commands. It became clear there was no safe means to detain the subject without unnecessarily endangering everyone that was now involved. Unable to investigate further, officers disengaged and left the area. Police found no evidence of a shooting at the original scene and no gunshot wounds, wound victims were reported. Now, once again, they left because people in the community told them to get the hell on. I have never seen this before, not in communities that I'm in, never. Did not even know it was a thing. Let's put him up, Seattle Chief of Police, okay? Adrian Diaz and East Precinct Captain Eric Sano. Buck stops with them. All right, Ben, thoughts here?
Yeah, I mean, okay, reading the comments from the police department is honestly hilarious because they're like, "They were obstructing us and they were hindering our ability to do this engagement." And like, come on, you were pointing a gun at a random innocent young man. Like, What would have happened? Like, let's be real. Everybody that stepped up and like participated and then telling those cops to like stand down, I think it's very fair to say that they like almost definitely saved that young man's life.
Oh yeah.
Because literally, how many times have we seen people complying with police officers and they still end up murdered? Right? Like, so literally kudos to everybody that stood up here. Yes. Because like fundamentally, like I think this is something we're gonna see more of, because as people have been protesting for years, as people have been demanding accountability for years, I mean, literally Atlanta has a Democratic city council and they still put up Cop City. Who are we supposed to vote for fundamentally? Like, and so we're at a point now where like going out and keeping each other safe in this way is really like the only thing that a lot of people feel that they have access to. And it took a lot of bravery for those people, quite literally, to stand in the line of sight to make sure that innocent man didn't die for no reason.
To those members of that community, thank you. Thank you.